Hi everyone, welcome to API Revision with WSO2 API Manager 4.0. This is a new feature introduced with the WSO2 API Manager 4.0 release. So today we will discuss what this feature brings to the API management capabilities with regards to WSO2 API Manager. I am Sampath Rajapaksha, software engineer from WSO2. So let's get started. First, let's get familiarized with the terminology used in this video, API revision. Let's see what is an API revision. API revision is a snapshot of an API at a particular given time. For example, the revision one depicted in the above picture is the state of the API 4 days ago. Current API. Current API is the current state of the API. The above picture shows the dropdown in the API which we can use to switch between current API and revisions. This is the state where API developers can make changes to the API. Deployment. Deployment is pushing the API into the runtime gateway environment. The above picture shows the deployment menu with multiple gateway environments in which API developers can select and deploy the API. Let's see what prompted us to come up with the API revision feature. In previous WSO2 API Manager versions, if the API developer makes changes to an API, the changes will instantly get reflected to the runtime gateways. Hence, in a production scenario, this will lead to severe issues if the changes applied aren't fully tested, and with the introduction of the revision feature, such issues can be mitigated easily. API revision feature provides capability to API developers to make changes to an API and test without affecting current API deployments and create a revision from the current API in which API runtime related artifact will be stored separately and then deploy that revision to a test environment and then validate the changes before making them available for API consumers. Also provide the ability to restore the current API to a previous stable revision if the latest changes done to the API isn't working properly. With the introduction of the revision feature now, there are four major steps to API development, as namely develop, deploy, test, and publish. Previously, deploy and publish were considered as single functionality. Also now, development phase is now divided into two categories, API configuration section and portal configuration section. This separation provides the API developer ability to distinguish the changes which affect the runtime deployment and which changes doesn't affect the runtime. So the changes done to the API configuration section affect the runtime, hence performing a new revision creation and deployment is necessary to make the new changes affect the runtime API. Changes to the portal configuration section doesn't affect the runtime gateway. It will only affect the API which is visible in the dev portal. Revisions are created from the current API, which is considered the latest or head state of the API. Currently, single API can create up to 5 revisions and after reaching the limit, need to delete a stale previous revision to continue creating new revisions. Single revision can be deployed into multiple gateway environments. Once we create a revision, we can't make changes to the revision, but once we restore a previous revision as the current API, then we can make relevant API changes. Key functionalities of the API revision feature provides ability to create, delete, and list revisions. Also provide ability to deploy or undeploy previously deployed revisions from the gateway environment. And provides capability to restore the API using a revision. Now let's see how we can do this in a real-world scenario. David is an API developer who is going to use WSO2 API Manager 4.0 to create an API, and let's see how he can utilize revision capabilities. David has already logged into the API publisher portal and has created an API, and the API is in created state. As I have mentioned previously, you can see four stages of API development in the API overview menu, and as well as portal and API configuration section in the left menu. In the drop-down, you can see now we are in the current API. When creating a new revision, we store registry artifact of the API and also store the database entries in the table which have API runtime related data. Hence, we have separated configuration which affect the runtime API as API configuration section. Other data which doesn't affect the runtime API is separated into the portal configuration section. Now let's see what should be done to promote API to enable performing deployments. Once David provides relevant business plans for the API, now the API has come to a stage where deployment can be performed. Then the API developer can navigate to the deployment menu section to perform the initial deployment. This is the initial deployment view when there are no previous deployments. You can see there are two gateway environments, namely default and QA gateway. First, we are going to deploy the API to the default environment. We can provide the necessary information as the description when deploying. Once we click the deploy button, it will create revision one from the current API and deploy the revision to the selected default environment. Now in the deployment menu, you will be able to see two sections as revisions and API gateways. In the revision section, you can see the newly created revision. When you hover over a revision icon, you should be able to view the meta information of a revision, such as description and created time. In the API gateway section, under the default environment, revision 1 is deployed, and in the QA gateway environment, there isn't any revision deployed yet. In the drop-down, now you can see a revision is available for the Vivin. We will get back to Vivin revision later in the demo. QA gateway can be used to perform testing. Now let's deploy the same revision 1 to QA gateway as well. API developer has the ability to select which environments to be shown and accessible through Dev Portal. David is selecting Dev Portal visibility through QA gateway as false, since he doesn't want to expose the internal testing gateway to API consumers. Since the API deployment requirement has been fulfilled, now the API can be tested through the publisher test console, and once the API developer is satisfied with the testing, API can be published so that the dev portal users can subscribe and invoke the API. Once the API is published, API is visible to the API consumers through API dev portal. As you can see, API consumers can only access default environment and not the QA testing environment, since the API developer set the QA gateway environment as false. Moving back to the API in the API publisher console, now let's make a change which affects the runtime. Here David wants to log the API request and is going to add a request path runtime message mediation policy to cater his requirements. Once select relevant policy, API developer needs to either perform save or save and deploy option. If the developer performs save only option, then needs to manually go to deployment menu and create a new revision and deploy. If the developer selects save and deploy option, the user is directed to deployment page after saving the API. Then onward, developer has the option to select relevant environment and deploy. Since this is a new change, developer has the ability to deploy the revision to a QA environment and then validate the change before making it available for API consumers. As you can see, revision 1 is deployed in the default environment and the revision 2, newly created one, is in the QA gateway. There are two ways in creating revision and deploying them. One is by clicking deploy new revision button, which will perform two functions as create new revision and deploy selected environment. Other method is you can create a revision separately and then deploy to relevant gateways manually. let's add few stale revisions so that the maximum revision count for the API is reached. Once the revisions per API reach 5, the developer needs to delete unused stale revisions in order to create a new revision. This can be performed manually by deleting revision or by using revision creation wizard, which provides the option to select stale revisions to be deleted before creating a new revision. Here we are providing stale revision 4 as the revision to be deleted and then providing a necessary description before creating new revision. So the new revision 6 is created now. API developer can view the created revisions by selecting the required revision using dropdown. When we move between the revision, we should be able to see the changes we did exist in each revision. We can only view the API revisions since they are immutable. Options such as save are disabled in the revision view. Now let's perform revision restore to restore the current API back to initial state. By clicking restore button in the revision 1, the change we did earlier get restored and the current API will get to initial state. When we move on to runtime environment section in the current API, as you can see, message mediation pop policy change we did earlier is now gone. But if we check the revision 2, still the message mediation change persists. Although the API is reverted back to the earlier state, hasn't affected the deployed revisions. API developer can delete unused revision to free up revision slots. Next, let's see what's the difference between API revision and API version. The difference between API revision and API version is the developer can create revisions for versioned APIs as well as, and the API version can be used in an instance where performing alteration to an API in which break or affect the consumer implementation contract. Such instances can be identified as altering resource names and adding new resources. As mentioned previously as well, API revision can be used to test the changes done beforehand before making it available for API consumers and as an efficient way to revert back to a stable revision in a case where the API is broken. API product revisioning. Same API revision capabilities apply for API product as well. API developer can create, view, deploy, undeploy, restore, and delete API product revisions as well. When creating API products, the dependent API's current API resources are used. So from this video, we focused on how WSO2 API Manager 4.0 API revision capabilities can be used to enhance API management methodologies for better developer experience. Hope this was useful to you and thank you for watching. See you next time.